Not only tell him, but perhaps tell the audience, really, who are listening, about what he calls SADA.
Yeah.
What is SADA and what are you doing about it?
Let me explain how SADA came about. There's a historical imbalance in development between the north and the south of the country.
Mm-hmm.
And it developed historically. Western education came from the south.
Mm-hmm.
And so education spread in the south, but the north was largely
illiterate. Came from Cape Coast, basically.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Exactly.
Uh-huh.
And under the British colonial government, they had a deliberate policy of keeping education out of the north because they said northerners were strong and mm-hmm. could work in the mines mm-hmm. and, you know, on the cocoa farms.
Security forces.
And they made very good policemen and soldiers. And so
like that is what... Sounds like Uganda.
That is what northerners were used uh-huh. for mostly.
Like Nigeria.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so it wasn't until a much later stage that education came to the north. Apart from that, we have imbalances in terms of natural resources and so on and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you have a country that is that imbalanced in terms of development, it doesn't make for a proper forward movement. We're seeing strong migration from the north to the south of people seeking economic opportunity.
Right.
So government's thinking was, why don't we create a new growth pole in the north with economic opportunity
mm-hmm.
so that the people there can also aspire to something and even create a situation where we can have reverse migration mm-hmm. of people coming from the south to the north.
Mm-hmm.
The north has a comparative advantage in agriculture and agribusiness. It's got wide fertile lands. All the tributaries of the Volta crisscross the north.
I've been there. I've been to Tamale.
You can do a lot of irrigation and
yes.
all that.
Mm.
So we conceptualize SADA. It's called the Savannah Accelerated Development Authority. Now, the mistake people make is they think SADA is an event. You know, we come, we dance, we party, close.
An incident.
SADA is
a process.
And we envision that it will take a 20-year period to achieve the full objectives of what we're envisioning. I just came out of a meeting with the World Bank. They've committed $60 million to agriculture, commercial agriculture in northern Ghana.
Mm-hmm.
That's the kind of thing we're doing. We have a donors conference coming up before the end of this month where we're getting all the bilateral partners together. Government is going to say what its commitment to SADA is financially, and we'll see what the commitment of the partners are. And we'll put up a budget. We've created a board.
Mm-hmm.
The board is active. And we have Pricewaterhouse that is doing the head hunting mm-hmm. for the chief executive and the senior officers.
Mm-hmm.
And so SADA is coming into being, and it will begin to deliver on the objectives that we have set for it.
What are